Joining us now with his take on the talks is Senator and Budget Committee member Michael Crapo. Thank you so much for coming in today.
Thank you, Shannon.
All right, and you heard the tail end of Doug's report there, the fact that both sides seem so dug in. At this point, do you see a light at the end of the tunnel?
Well, I certainly see a pathway forward if we can get out of the paradigm we are in right now. If you notice what's been said, we're in the age-old battle of should we raise taxes on the rich or should we cut spending that helps the poor? And those politics work really well, but it doesn't work well for a solution. The Gang of Six, or Five as we are now, that built on the Fiscal Commission plan is changing the fiscal paradigm, and I think that's the approach we need to take. Everything does have to be on the table, but the approach that we need to take with regard to the entire process is to grow our economy and grow our nation's strength, and do that through approaching revenue from tax reform rather than just tax hikes. And approaching the spending side in terms of meaningful, thoughtful approaches that will actually help us protect that safety net.
Okay, you mentioned tax reform. At this point, we can't seem to reach a deal on many things in Washington. I mean, we had all those continuing resolutions just to keep the government funded and keep it going. Now we have these debt and deficit issues. Is there going to be real appetite for actually reforming the tax code?
Well, unfortunately, because of the politics I just mentioned, the age-old politics of fighting over increasing taxes versus cutting spending, the appetite yet hasn't grown for true tax reform. But I see it growing, and I see it growing for a couple of reasons. One, the real issue here is growth. We've got to get our economy back on a strong, dynamic track. And the way to do that is through controlling spending, yes, but through reforming our tax policy. If you look at our tax code today, you would have a hard time finding one that is more unfair, more complex, more expensive to comply with, and frankly, more anti-competitive to U.S. business interests. And we can have a phenomenally dynamic impact on our economy if we reform the tax code. And we can do that by looking at those so-called tax expenditures that the president wants to look at and actually reducing rates with those and then generating phenomenal growth that will provide revenue for deficit reduction.
Okay, I want to ask you to respond to something that one of your colleagues, the Democratic Senator Chuck Schumer, had to say as things were sort of falling apart last night. There were some things that have been scaled back with House Speaker John Boehner saying we're not going for the big, huge deal now. This is part of what Senator Schumer had to say. The president has called the Republicans bluff by offering them exactly the type of grand bargain they said they wanted, only to have it rejected. Some on the Republican side would like to confuse the issue by pretending it was tax hikes on the middle class that they were trying to prevent, but none were ever on the table. Your response?
I suspect that that's more of the grand politics that you hear playing out there, because it was never put on the table, the kind of reform that John Boehner's been asking for, the kind of reform that I'm talking about. What was put on the table was, again, tax hikes on the wealthy so that we can do less spending reduction. We've got to get out of that paradigm. And we've got to get out of those politics. Some of those politics actually poll really well. And one of the problems we're having right now is because pollsters are at full employment and politicians are following what they are telling them. And it's telling them, on the one hand, don't put Social Security, don't put Medicare on the table, don't even talk about those things. And on the other hand, just talk about taxing the rich and you'll be fine. But that doesn't help us get to a solution.
Well, we certainly hope that you find one. We know you're busy not only with the Gang of Six or Five or whatever it currently stands to be, but with everything else being negotiated on the Hill. Thanks for making time for us.
Thank you.